The demand of bread is high. The process is simple. The workers spend the whole day making bread. People roll in throughout the day. Most individuals come in once in the morning and again in the evening. Bread is subsidized by the government, so they legally can't charge more than 20 cent dinar, which is 10 cents US dollar. The bakery does get reimbursed by the government. If you have nothing to eat, you buy bread. If you make a three-course meal, you buy bread. Meals are farmed to table and cooked fresh. If whoever is making dinner expects six guests, they will make enough food to feed 12. The people of Tunisia all want peace. There is no hatred or big divide between groups or individuals. They recognize that they're all Tunisians with civic duties. The rebels and the citizens who supported them didn't have all the proper tools and supplies they needed for the revolution, but they used what they had. Through social media like Facebook and Twitter, they communicated to different parts of the country and corresponded to different individuals around the world, such as news outlets and military. They never gave up, but continued to push forward with the idea of hope for a better future for generations to come. They were successful. The president and his family did leave the country. A fair democracy was finally created after years of oppression. People are happy and they feel free to do whatever they want. This is a local beach that only people from the community come out to celebrate and enjoy. We packed the car and headed back north. The northern part of the country, Tunis, Sidi Bou Said, Damart, is very modern. The nicest hotels and restaurants are located here. Soccer players, foreign leaders, prime ministers, and other wealthy individuals travel to this area. The nightclubs in Tunis and Damart are very trendy and popular. The same crowd of people and DJs that travel to this region of the country go to Ibiza and Sicily. It is a very wealthy area. The coastlines with multi-million dollar homes. The nicest foreign cars are found in the streets. A couple of the biggest palaces the old president owned are located in this area. Tourism is also one of the major industries. We stayed at Mövenpick, a five-star hotel in Damart. Women are free to wear whatever they want without being judged. Businesses expand without the competition of government-owned stores. New shops are being built. People are practicing their individual rights. It's crazy to think so much has changed in such a little amount of time. The Tunis souks are thriving. It is an immersion of tradition and modern society. People go on with their daily lives, but knowing they have the power to choose how to live it. A lot of the souks have handmade items. Some are made right in front of everyone, right on the streets. Things are positively changing. Tunisia is an inspiration to all countries. It is modern proof that with collaboration from citizens of a whole country, it is possible to overturn a corrupt government and establish an organized democracy. Through patience and willpower, Tunisia did it. Prior to this trip, all I knew was what I heard on the news. I was curious to see the state of the country and how it's changed. I've seen it all now. I have a good sense and reconnection of where I'm from. I'm coming back home to Naperville with a better understanding of how life can be a bubble. And it's beyond important to pop that bubble and stay globally aware of others' reality and not to be blinded from it. But if you can breathe it, I can breathe it. Brave it all for you. Call me anytime you can see the light.